Jack's going to throw up. Jack's going to throw up. Hold on.
What's up, YouTube? Okay, so today, me and Brant and Greg set out to do a catch and cook, but a catch and cook comparison between Jack Crevalle and a ladyfish, aka skipjack. So here's what happened.
All right, guys, so it is 5:41, and I just got in the car. It's kind of cold out today. It's ridiculously cold. So I'm gonna head over to the marina and meet up with Brant and Greg. For this catch and cook episode, we got an epic sunrise and the guys are waiting on me. I think they're giving me that foul look like I'm late. Give me that pearly smile. Give me that look. There you go. Put the shades on. Oh!
Ooh. A little warning next time, Captain.
Sorry.
It's low, so hopefully it starts swinging through.
Look at all the pogies.
Pogies everywhere!
Look at all the pogies.
Take two! Alright, so I just went on an epic rant and the camera wasn't on. But we're in search of a Jack Crevalle. Brant is gonna show me where to get him. I've got a cheap Walmart bait that they're probably gonna straighten the hooks out on. Greg's gonna be motivation on this trip. So
with all these pogies in here, there may be a big jack or tarpon back here.
Yeah, I would like a tarpon, that'd be awesome.
And throw that Rapala V-shaped skitterwalk. We're gonna see what we can come up with on this water bite.
Dancing on the water, dancing. Like that country music song.
Maybe a little walking the dog.
I saw stars,
maybe a couple pauses.
Dancing on the water. Brant's got a fish. Oh, he's got a jack.
There's a jack.
Nice.
That's our target species. Now you know what we can do. With
that's
this
dinner guy? Right there.
What we can do with this guy is we can. Oh, you just got a blow up. Yep. We can cook him whole, just like we did.
Nice. I'm all about cooking them whole.
The other day. Oh, there he is. Fish on.
Woo!
Fish on. It's a ladyfish. It's a ladyfish. Ah! There he is.
Cooking. 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 Oh, I got a fish. I got one.
Jack's got one. Oh, Jack's woo! On. Jack's got him a ladyfish.
Might have to cook this bad boy.
You gonna cook him?
Maybe.
Jack's want some ladyfish.
Jump, jump, jump.
Oh, there he is. There he is. Oh, he's in the trolling motor.
Oh, geez.
He came off.
Way better than a bass. I'll take a ladyfish over a bass any day.
Bite way better than a bass.
Oh, yeah, man. They do their little skip across the water like a tarpon. They fall like a stud, though. My drag was a little tight.
A lot of action, guys. A lot of action. This is intense. What you think,
it's Motley? An intense trash can cook-off.
Jack! You got the bottom?
I got the bottom.
Got a rockfish.
I'm not talking about strikes.
I got it.
The bottom.
It was like, it felt like it was moving, but I was like, no, that's the boat. Oh, no, I got somebody's line.
We're on the board with a ladyfish and a jack. We're looking good. Looking real
good. It's a trophy stringer right there.
Dude,
you're all over him.
Got him. I'm on fire. I caught a heater. You just had an explosion on yours, too.
I was looking at yours.
It's another ladyfish.
Nice! Ladyfish steaks.
Oh!
Oh! They ain't just feeling it. They're not feeling the boat ride home. They're not feeling it.
All right, guys, so we're actually thinking about putting on a trash can fishing tournament in Pensacola, Florida.
And it's gonna be epic.
All of our subscribers to the fishing tournament right here in Pensacola to target trash fish. What y'all think about
that? It's
gonna
be epic.
It's gonna be epic. It's gonna be open to anybody.
I'm gonna catch the biggest lizard fish on the planet.
We want our subscribers to come to the fishing tournament, to enter the fishing tournament. Whoever catches the biggest trash fish, the most trash fish.
Good thing our standards aren't high.
Yeah.
Oh, it was a stick. It was a stick. False alarm. There you go, Greg. Oh!
Oh, I'm on.
Is it a ladyfish?
Oh! Yeah, I do. I got a jack.
Nice. Got a screamer.
That was a drag screaming jack right there, boys.
Why can't I get a jack? Why can't Jack catch a jack?
We're gonna throw him back.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, Greg's on.
Woo!
Greg's on.
That's
oh! Oh, Greg's not on.
Is that a good fish?
Yeah.
They're chasing.
Dude, give me a Jimmy Houston. Give me a Jimmy Houston. Hey, I'm all about them skipjack steaks. That's where the money's at.
All right, so as of right now, I got a ladyfish, lost a ladyfish. Brant's got a jack and a ladyfish. Greg
lost a couple fish.
He's lost a couple. And the Catch and Cook episode is on. Jack Crevalle versus ladyfish. And we are going to do a trash can tournament, if y'all are interested. It's going to be the most epic. There's going to be the most epic pinfish ever caught. There's going to be some stud cell cats and at least a handful of ladyfish entered, and it's going to be epic. So y'all got to join. It's going to be hilarious. It's time to relax the fishing industry. Take a little pain off the redfish. Also, I can get back to these ladyfish.
I'm going to catch the best hardhead catfish on the planet. Oh, that was a good jump right there. Dude, it's all about a dozen ladyfish in the boat. That's what it's all about. If you're not running a dozen ladyfish, you just ain't got skills. Nope.
Oh, got him.
Woo! Fish on!
Jack's on!
Fish on like Donkey Kong!
Jack's on! What we working with?
I got me a side hooked ladyfish. Woo! Ladyfish. Let me leader this bad boy right here. There he is. Woo! Gotta be careful with this bad boy. He gets you hooked real fast. Man, golly, calm down. Now you done got yourself twice hooked. Ever.
Got him. Fish on.
Fish on, baby. Fish on. You got you a stud pinfish right there. That's what I'm talking about. You got him in the mouth, too.
We could enter him in the trash can.
That's an entry right there. That could win the pinfish division.
I got him right in the mouth.
Man.
Right in the mouth.
We're gonna have to do a 5-inch limit on pinfish.
We're currently in a situation right now. We got a mass casualty situation. We've got one mirror dime in the bushes over there that has to be rescued.
It's in the rocks.
Oh, it's in the rocks. Brant's doing some great driving skills over here. I see some fish getting blown up. Did you see that fish get thrown out of the water over there?
Yep.
Wow.
Jumping or something.
Uh-oh, are we double?
Back up.
Oh, jeez.
We're getting shallow.
I'm just gonna sit over here. This is boatmanship right here.
There's some mullet.
Dude, you might be hung up on another pinfish. He might be trying to spool you right now.
Epic pinfish.
This is the biggest pinfish on the planet.
Free? Got it.
Yeah. Never fear.
Losing the $8.
Hey, that was a brand new mirror dime from Outcast. Can't lose it.
Not losing the $8 lure, sorry.
Mine was a dollar from Bait Bonanza at Walmart.
Got a trout. Greg's got either a trout or a ladyfish.
Give me a jump. Give me some air.
Ladyfish. Greg's got a ladyfish.
Oh, he didn't even jump.
Spit it. Oh, I gotta touch it.
Watch out. Hey, that's how he did me a while ago.
All right, so we just finished up catching some jacks. Brant caught all of them, not gonna lie. And then, I mean, he was like 4 for 4. It was ridiculous, he was on fire. Me and Greg struck out, but they're still in the live well. So we are going to try some Jack Crevalle, the little ones. And then we're gonna try a ladyfish. How are you feeling about that ladyfish back there, Brant?
I've already eaten one, so. I'm gonna let you try it.
Maybe we can do a little zest on him. Put a little extra spices, some Tabasco, because if you've ever been in the Army, Tabasco fix all MREs. Right.
Everything.
It fixes everything. It's like sriracha sauce. It makes everything better. All right, well, we had an epic time. We got what we came for, a Jack Crevalle and a skipjack. And got me some ice for it.
because hey, can't let our fine cuisine spoil in the morning sun. But anyway, guys, if y'all are looking for an epic charter trip, make sure you hit up Brant Peacher, angler up. You're gonna have a good time.
Jack did some ice on the fish. Here's what we're left with. We got one ladyfish, two jackets.
All right, guys, so we just got the fish back to Brant's Ponderosa here, the angler up compound. And we already bled them. And well, we bled the Jack Crevalle, just cut right underneath his throat, bled it out in the water, put it on ice. Same thing with the skipjack. We didn't bleed the skipjack, but we put the skipjack on ice. And now we're gonna go in here and I'm gonna show you how we're gonna cook them. We're gonna cook them very simple, just like normally you would cook most fish, to try to get an accurate comparison. And we're gonna see how this goes. I think it's gonna be real wild and really entertaining.
It's me in the flesh.
So y'all are bad boy right now.
Y'all are already at it. Just gonna gut him and
look at that. Look at all those tasty guts right there.
Knife real quick like this, and it's super simple. They don't have big scales, but they do have some scales. So we want to get it off right there, just like that. Just gonna go heavy salt and pepper.
All right, guys. So we just got the fish scaled. Took the scales off the jack. They don't have very big scales. Put some sea salt on them and some pepper, and we cut the slits in the fish to make sure they cook thoroughly and our seasoning gets in there. And now we're fixing to put them in the skillet. Brant's really nervous about the skipjack, so I think that's gonna be on the fly decision, and it's gonna be a very interesting situation. Fact.
Grease is popping, boys. All right, dudes, that grease is popping. We're about to put them on right here. What y'all think about that?
Let's look at excelente.
Woo!
Hey guys, check this out. You know what you're 100% salt life when there's a Lowrance unit on top of the microwave.
I don't know.
Alright, so the fish is almost done. Brant is really excited to eat this Jack Crevalle.
Woo! Yeah!
It looks like something we caught in a sabiki raid the other day called a hardtail or blue runner. Check this out.
Woo! Yeah.
All right, everybody. So we just moved out here to the patio and we are ready to eat the Jack Crevalle right here. And we're gonna eat the Jack Crevalle, and then I'm gonna go back and try to do something with the skipjack, and or the ladyfish, whatever you want to call it. So this is gonna be like a two-part thing right here. We're ready. On cue.
We're about to eat some Jack Crevalle. We've got two Jack Crevalles right here. Check them out. Eat them whole.
I got my eating stick right here. I'm ready. They got a bronze look
to
them.
We're about to eat them. Now, I've eaten Jack before, and it wasn't bad.
Oh, I get to do the honors.
He's been so excited about eating this Jack Crevalle.
You got that one right there?
I'm trying to make sure I get the skin involved.
Ooh, that looks good.
Let's see if it's
what
any
good. What do you think? No, I don't think he likes it.
That's a look of contemplation.
It's
right
not
there.
Bad. It's a... I got a lot of skin on it, so let me get one without the skin.
All right, do the honors. Do the honors. I'm just gonna hang out.
Bring it over.
What do you think, Greg?
That piece wasn't actually bad, but I didn't have any skin or anything on it.
Yeah, the piece without the skin was better.
Kind of tastes like those cigar minnows the other day.
Yeah. Okay, here goes nothing.
Yeah, cigar
right
minnows.
Here.
I mean, I don't think it's like the best fish I've had, but it's by far not the worst.
I mean, it's definitely, it has almost like a crab meat texture.
Yeah, that's a good call.
It definitely has a crab meat texture, but as far as the flavor goes, there's a lot better fish out there to eat than Jack Crevalle. It's not bad though. I mean, if you want to keep one and eat it, especially these small ones, and we bled it. So, I mean, it's not bad.
No, it's in the seasoning. It depends on how you season it. That's with any fish I've noticed, is how you season it. Your batter, your the cook, But this was cooked very just across the board, salt and pepper.
Yeah, I mean, we cooked it really plain just because we wanted to see what the fish tastes like. And I mean, it's really not bad.
I mean, and it's kind of a firmer meat, so it's not mushy or anything firm, like that. So it's easy to chew. It doesn't.
I mean, for a bachelor like that's trying to bulk up in the gym, get a little protein in his life, it's better than that tilapia you get. I'll say
okay,
that.
Bottom line is, Jack Crevalle is not the greatest fish to eat, but it's
called. But it's edible.
But it is edible.
It's edible.
But
tastes
I can see why people throw them back. I mean, honestly, I mean, it's just not.
I mean, if you compare it to like a grouper, you know, or a flounder or anything like that.
I cooked it a little different last time. I took the skin off and cooked the fillet, and that was better with the skin off. It took some of the fishiness away. So I feel like that if you take these were small, so we wanted to cook them whole. Mm-hmm. They're kind of fishy, kind of strong. Not the best flavor.
I'd say keep the skin off of it.
All right, so we're done with the jack.
Maybe fillet it.
We're done with the jack, but we're not done with jack.
Yeah. Hey, he's got one more thing for me around
Jack's
here.
Jack's been talking all morning about how he's wanting to try ladyfish.
Yeah, I was reading up on recipes.
We might have to let him do that.
We
one
did
all by
happen
himself.
To catch a ladyfish. Greg and I have opted out. We're not eating ladyfish.
Chickens.
Jack is going to eat a ladyfish, so you guys stay tuned.
You're ladyfishing out.
I'll probably try it.
You guys stay tuned.
If it sits there cooked in front of me, I'll probably try it.
Here we go. We're going to do this.
All right. So y'all stay
tuned. Dude, this thing is so mushy.
So mushy? Hey, it looks like a chicken tender that's been beaten and battered. What do you think about cooking skipjack? Thoughts?
I feel really strange. This is so awkward. I'm not even kidding.
It looks like one of those deer tenders that you hammer with a hammer and it gets all mushy. All right, so my initial thoughts is I'm in for it, okay? So this thing looks like, you know how when you get like a back strap and you gotta hammer it with one of those meat tenderizers? That's what the fillet looks like, and it's basically like looks
it's like a
sliver of mush, and he put salt and pepper on it and he split it in the skillet. So the goal of these catch and cooks isn't really to show you the best recipe, it's to say, can you eat it and what does it taste like, and that we haven't died, because me and Greg and Brant have yet to go to the ER, #America, #health insurance. So
I think
we're winning so far. You know, they haven't got my name at the ER yet. All right, it's time. He just brought it out.
All right.
See it sitting right there on the table? I can't believe I'm about to eat a ladyfish. Greg's in! He's gonna eat it with me.
So Brant is opting out of this one. He catches so much of these that...
We're in the trenches right now trying to eat this bad boy.
All right, so we're back. We've got our ladyfish right here. Jack and Greg are gonna eat it. I'm not. Here we go.
This looks like one of those nasty things you'd pull out of an MRE. Right. That's what it looks like.
Look at that. It's all beat up and looks kind of...
not happening.
That's a swirl.
We got Tabasco sauce. That might
Jack,
cover it
by
up.
All means, go ahead.
All right, I'm going with the light side.
Woo, yeah, that looks good.
It looks like it's been cooked in a microwave.
That is so gross. I'm not even kidding.
Is it done? Oh my goodness, I mean, look at that, it just...
Jack's going to throw up! Jack's going to throw up!
That's live, folks, that right there is no joke.
What do you think, Jack?
It's terrible, absolutely terrible.
I'm so scared right now, I don't know what to do it.
You're up, Greg. Eat it, eat it!
All right, Greg, go.
We have to caption the moment. Caption the moment.
I've got a very, look at that. I've got a very mushy nugget in my hand right now. And on my finger. Oh, God.
He spit it out. I don't know it was like a combination between the texture of it being like cooked in a microwave for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And the bones, and it's got like an aftertaste to it. It's got a serious aftertaste.
You ever have like one of those chicken sandwiches out of a microwave?
Yes, that's
Boom.
It.
Boom. That's the consistency right there.
Oh, you know when you're in high school and they've got those like Like, we had these like Chick-fil-A sandwiches that had been in there for a while, and they would heat them back up. That is what it tastes like. Like an MRE. You know those chicken tenders and the MRE that are in there?
Yeah, the chicken patty.
Yeah, that's what it tastes like.
Not good. Not good at all. That was.
I'm gonna have this aftertaste in my mouth.
That was a horrible idea.
Now you know why I opted out of eating the ladyfish. I wasn't gonna have any part of that.
Just don't eat it, guys. Don't try it.
Redfish.
I think when they say that you can eat it as a patty, the season.
I do not to eat it. I mean, it was.
When they eat it as a patty, I think it's the seasoning that allows you to eat it, and all the other stuff that's in it.
He didn't want to sway.
Brant was smart and tried to try that one. All right, guys. So before I go pound a jug of water, I hope you guys like the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and follow me on Jack Motley on Instagram and Brant Peacher on Angler Up and YouTube on Angler Up and Instagram on Angler Up and Greg Ammons Outdoors both on YouTube and on Instagram. And I'll see you guys later. Man, that would taste terrible.